It's very early in the morning and I'm heading over Highway 17 to Silicon Valley and the Bay Area. And thinking about the continuing job problems in California that continues to get worse, and wondering how government at all levels has just not been able to come to grips with exactly what is going on with these job losses, because as we're now beginning to see, the housing market is continuing to be weak or actually slide because of job losses. For instance, as the regular loans are now catching up with those subprime loans in the foreclosure race. How do you create jobs? Where do you create jobs? It's not the sort of issue where you go and have a forum, have a committee, build consensus. Sooner or later you have to stand up and say, this is how jobs are created. This is how we do it. This is what we need to do. We need the leadership and we need the direction. You cannot put jobs on the back burner. The biggest mistake that the Obama administration has made is in not recognizing the fact that business as usual is gone. It's no longer the way it was. There is, as they say here in Silicon Valley, a new normal. And those jobs aren't coming back. We have to create incentives. We have to create startups. We have to do things like make it easier for companies to come to Silicon Valley and start up and get going, as opposed to making it harder by putting more taxes and burdens and regulations on them. The figure I heard yesterday, what we need to create some 15 million jobs to catch up where the U.S. was 2 or 3 years back, and 3 million jobs a year, that would be a 5-year project, almost virtually unheard of, not impossible, but pretty much undoable, not realistic. And so far that has been the unrealistic has been the approach that government at all levels has taken on the issue of job creation and employment. From Silicon Valley, Northern California, this is the Jack D. Deal Network.